Hello, good morning. Welcome to the channel Awesome Learning. So today we are going to discuss about the sporophyte and gametophyte. Many of the children have asked me this question that they are not able to distinguish between a sporophyte and a gametophyte. They generally get confused. So just to clear that confusion, children, I have come with this video. So children, let me show you. Suppose this is a plant. This is a plant in front of you. Okay, the stem, the leaves, and this is the flower. Now the flower is having a female part. This is the female part, and these are the male part of the flower. That is the anther and the filament. Now we all know that anther, I have discussed about the structure of anther. Now we know that anther is bilobed, and there are four microsporangias. We have done this, and each microsporangium will have microspores, and those will give rise to pollen grains and gametes. So this we have done. You can watch the video. So now here I am going to tell you how to differentiate and how to be clear which part is the sporophyte and which part is the gametophyte. Now children, microsporangium has microspores, right? Microsporangium will give rise to microspores, and we all know that angiosperms are the plants which are the plant body is diploid. So these are the plants where the main plant body is diploid. Now there are many other species of plants where the main plant body is haploid. So exceptions are there. Few plants have the haploid plant body. But because we are going to discuss here about angiosperms, as our chapter is related to sexual reproduction in flowering plants, so we are going to discuss about angiosperms. Now we all know that this plant body is diploid, that is 2N, and will give rise to spores. Now if the plant body which is diploid is giving rise to spores and the spores are haploid, so we all know that which division will occur? Yes, of course, meiosis will occur. So because the main plant body is diploid, so we call the main plant body to be the sporophyte, and sporophyte will give rise to spores. The sporophyte will give rise to spores, which are N. So the sporophyte is 2N, and these sporophytes will give rise to spores, which are N. So of course the division will be meiosis. The division here will be meiosis. So the sporophyte will undergo meiosis to form spores. This I have again written it for you. Now children, microspores, we all know that in microsporangia, I have discussed in the previous videos that microsporangia will give rise to microspores, and microspores are haploid. Okay, so these microspores will again undergo mitosis, because already they are haploid, and they will give rise to pollen grain, right? The pollen grain, which will be a 2-cell stage in 60% and 40 cells in 40%, it can be of 3-cell stage. This also was discussed. So the pollen grain is again haploid. Now this pollen grain will again undergo mitosis, as in the case of 40%, okay, and will give rise to male gametes, which are again haploid. So all the pollen grain, whether it is 60% or whether it is 40%, I must tell you that in 60% cases, pollen grain is shed at 2-cell stage. Shed means they are released out from the anther at the 2-celled stage. Now what are the 2 cells? One is the vegetative cell, which is the bigger one, and the other one is the generative cell, which is the smaller one. But in other 40% cases, the pollen grain undergoes one more division. The generative cell undergoes one more division, which is mitosis, to give rise to 2 male gametes. And of course, this cell is already present. This is the vegetative cell. So the generative cell will undergo another division, which will be mitosis, and it will give rise to 2 male gametes, right? So again, let me clear out the written that I have explained, because otherwise you will get confused. Let me again explain you, as I told you here, children, that microspores will undergo mitosis to give rise to pollen grain. Now these pollen grain, either they will do this mitosis at the same time as in case of 40% plants, or this division will take place later on as in case of 60% plants. Division will occur in all the type of plants, but the difference lies in the timing. In 60% plants, this division takes place later on, but in 40% plants, this will take place back to back when the pollen grains are formed. Immediately after that, the third division will also occur, that is mitosis, and the two male gametes are formed. So I hope this is clear now. So children, in sporophyte, spores are formed. So sporophyte, which is diploid, will give rise to spores, which are haploid. Now these spores will undergo mitosis to give rise to gametophyte. Okay, and gametophyte will give rise to gametes. Naam se hi samajh aa raha hai ki gametophyte will give rise to gametes. Now here in this case, angiosperms, who is the gametophyte? Who is giving rise to gametes? Tell me, who is the gametophyte? From where are these gametes formed? Of course, the gametophyte is the pollen grain. Now, the pollen grain are giving rise to the gametes. So, here in case of angiosperm, the gametophyte, pollen grain is the gametophyte, and the main plant body is the sporophyte. So, I hope I am clear. So now you must have understood which one is called sporophyte, which one is known as the sporophyte, and which one is known as the gametophyte, and why do we call them. The sporophyte are always 2N, the main plant body, they will give rise to spores, okay, and these spores will undergo mitosis, which are N, and they will give rise to gametophyte, and the gametophyte will undergo again mitosis, and they will give rise to male gametes, again N. I hope now this is clear.